Families, coaches, and baseball fans alike flock to Cary, North Carolina to watch over 750 athletes compete in 70 games, all vying for the same goal: to represent their country by playing on one of the United States of America's national baseball teams, who have won 14 medals over the past 5 years. Of these athletes, 32 will be selected to participate in the 2012 National Team Trials, all through the National Team Identification Series. Hello and thank you for joining us here at USABaseball.com. I'm TJ Scholl. Over the course of this program, we'll take a look back at the 2011 National Team Identification Series, which was held right here for the third consecutive year at USA Baseball's National Training Complex in Cary, North Carolina, September 9th through the 11th. We'll also announce the names of players who have been selected to participate in the 2012 USA Baseball National Team Trials event. This is the NTIS Selection Show. USA Baseball, along with its local partner, the Greater Raleigh CVB, brought in 756 athletes from across the country to compete in Cary at the USA Baseball National Training Complex. In our look back at an outstanding weekend of competition at the NTIS, let's first hear from USA Baseball's Executive Director and CEO, Paul Seiler.
Just like we do with every program in USA Baseball, the hope is as you identify and create, in this case, the National Team Identification Series, a new event for us, is that what it is on day one is not what it's going to be on year three, year five. So we've seen just unbelievable growth, as evidenced in the symposium that we had when we opened the event Thursday night, over 1,200 people in the ballroom, all the positive comments, how it's grown not only for the 3 days here in the facility, but also in the reach that it has in terms of nationally and the different players and parents who are touched by it on a local level, regional level, and then ultimately for the 42 teams that end up here in Cary over the weekend. So it's already grown in leaps and bounds in the 3 years that it's been on the board, and we see nothing but positive growth moving forward as well.
The NTIS got off to a great start with the second NTIS Symposium held Thursday night at the Embassy Suites RDU in Cary. USA Baseball invited the NCSA, an athletic recruiting organization, to speak at the symposium, but also included presentations from a representative from the Major League Scouting Bureau and former USA Baseball national team coaches. Players and parents also heard from Bob Watson, who won gold with the 2000 Olympic team, as well as from big league vet and 1995 18U national team member, Jody Garrett. To start off our NTIS weekend overview, we stop first at the 13U age group. Let's hear from some of this year's participants and coaches.
It feels like I'm a lot older with all the scouts around, just talking with them.
Being able to go to other countries, play other countries, represent the U.S., best players in the U.S.
You know, we pick kids from around the country and we try to get the best baseball players that we can find, and I think we do. And it just seems that the best baseball players around are also the best people, the best character.
The 13U NTIS evaluation team looks to keep the rich 14U tradition alive by choosing 16 players to attend the 2012 USA Baseball 14U National Team Trials.
The NTIS for us was a great start. Looking ahead to 2012, it got us 16 great players, really as talented as a group as we've ever had. Coming from the NTIS, the depth this year was incredible. We got to see great players from the Northeast down to Florida, all the way from the East Coast to the West Coast. So we feel really great about the 16 athletes that we've selected, and we're looking forward to a great start for 2012.
The 14U national team wasn't the only program to win gold over the summer. The 16U national team won its sixth consecutive championship in the 2011 IBAF AA World Championships.
From a 16U perspective, the NTIS has been great the past couple years. In 2010, we had three kids out of the eight we selected end up making a team. One ended up being tournament MVP and USA Baseball's Player of the Year, and that was Alex Bregman. And then this past year, or earlier this year, three of the eight kids we selected from last year's NTIS ended up making a team, one of which, Bryson Brigman, was all-tournament second base and led the tournament in hits. And was great for us out of the leadoff spot. So it's been really outstanding to have these eight kids each year, and actually this year we feel the best about the overall quality of the eight kids coming in that we have since the NTIS started. And on top of the 8 kids we have coming in, we've got a list of about 25 follows that we're really excited to see in 8-9 months or so once our tournaments come around in June.
Let's hear from some of the participants about the possibilities of joining this winning ball club.
Well, the opportunities, it's almost not expressible. It was said in the symposium, standing and listening to your national anthem with your hand on your heart, your hand is literally moving. It's a great opportunity. It makes you appreciate your country and how great competition in baseball really is for all of us. Coaches, players, moms and dads, are you kidding? It's awesome.
Competition is great. It's really competitive. Makes you want to do your best. You got people watching you from every corner. You got attitude's got to be straight in the dugout.
This is actually a great opportunity because there's a lot of colleges here, and it's just great.
It would be an absolute dream come true if I get to go around the world and just represent my country. Just even just wearing USA right now makes me proud.
Our final group of NTIS teams comes from the 17U age group, where invited players will compete in the 2012 Junior World Championships. Let's hear from some of our participants as well as a member of the evaluation staff.
Obviously, we were selecting 8 players from the recently completed NTIS who would be directly invited to next year's 18U National Team Trials, but it also was an opportunity for us to start our Tournament of Stars player pool and see what the 2012, 13, and even 14 classes have for national team candidates.
Means a lot. Just to be invited says a lot about your character and how good of a ball player you are. And I mean, to just be invited out here is an honor.
It's just phenomenal to see these guys come in, develop their game, grow with USA Baseball, grow with the program, and then go on to have very successful collegiate and professional careers.
Now that we've taken a look back at the exciting weekend of baseball, it's finally time to announce the players who will be joining us in the 2012 USA Baseball National Team Trials events. Congratulations to all the athletes. And that does it for us here at USABaseball.com. The NTIS once again showcased a wealth of talent and also gave USA Baseball a glimpse into the future of potential Team USA athletes. We want to thank you for tuning in to the NTIS Selection Show, and we hope to see you at a Team USA Baseball event in the future.